Hello students, in this video we are going to study the chapter that is food, where does it come from, and this is the part 2 of that chapter. And in first part we have already studied that what is food, what is the function of food, what are the importance of food and variation of food, etc. And in this video we are going to study sources of human food. And we already know that there are two sources of human foods. These are plants and animals. From plants we can get different types of cereals, pulses, vegetables, flowers, dry fruits, sugar, oils, and tea and coffee. And from animals we get different types of meat, chicken, eggs, milk and milk products. So let us study in detail. At first, the food that we get from plant. The first one is cereals. What are cereals? The food grains that form our main diet, and these are rich in mainly carbohydrates, wheat, rice, maize, jowar, and bajra. Are the examples of cereals. These food grains contains mainly carbohydrates. Pulses are very important for us because pulses are rich in proteins. And you already know what are the functions of proteins. It makes new cells and it also repairs the damaged cells and tissues of the body, and it also helps in growing. So you know that growing children needs more proteins than adult. So proteins are very important to us. And what are the sources of proteins? Pulses. Pulses are the main sources of proteins. Pulses are just like gram, pigeon pea, soya bean, lentils. These are the main sources of pulses, and pulses become more nutrients when make sprouts from pulses. And perhaps you know that how can we make sprouts. We wait any type of pulses at least 12 hours, then drain it and keep it more 12 hours, then we see that sprouts are germinated, and pulses are germinates. So these germinate pulses are called sprouts, and sprouts are more nutrients than pulses because it contains proteins and vitamin B complex. Third source of plants that we get is vegetable. We eat different parts of the vegetables. Root. We eat root of the vegetables, sweet potato. Sweet potato is eaten as root. Carrot and radish. Stem. We eat stem, potato, onion and ginger. These are eaten as stem. Leaves. Some vegetables are eaten as leaves, and the vegetables which are eaten as leaves are spinach, cabbage, and lettuce. Flowers. Some vegetables are eaten as flowers. Broccoli, cauliflower, and banana are eaten as flowers. Broccoli, cauliflower. And banana are eaten as flowers. Dry fruits. We get dry fruits from plums, and dry fruits are also very important to us because dry fruits contains minerals, vitamins and proteins, and the dry fruits which are eaten mostly are groundnut, walnut, cashew nut, groundnut, walnut, cashew nut, and coconut. After that, we eat sugar, and we use sugar in different types of sweets and in making tea and coffee. We get sugar from sugar cane and beetroot. These plants give us sugar, oils. The plants that give us oil are mustard, sunflower, groundnut, and coconut. These plants give us oil. Spices. What are spices? Spices are those food grains that makes our food tasty, and the main spices that we use in our kitchen are cloves, cardamom, turmeric, black pepper, and coriander. These are the main spices that we eat and that we use in our kitchen. Tea and coffee. Tea and coffee are also very important because elder person, when they get up, they like to take tea or coffee. And tea or coffee are called stimulants because they contain a substance called caffeine that make stimulants us. Now come to our second point, that is food that we get from animals. From animals, the first food that we get is meat and milk products. And you know that for getting milk, we rear mainly cow and buffalo. And some rural areas, people rear camel for getting milk. But the main sources of milk are cows and buffaloes. Meat are the rich sources of proteins, and the main source of meats are goat and sheep, chicken, the main source of chicken are hen and turkey, and chicken are the also important source of proteins, honey. Honey is obtained by honeybee. That means it is also the source of animals, and honey contains minerals and vitamins. And you know that minerals and vitamins are very important to us because it protects us from diseases and eggs. Eggs also contains proteins. So these items we can get from animals. That's all. Thank you so much for watching this video.